The following is an HRL Twin Cities presentation.
It was a first of its kind event, as Wifflers from around the league joined in some grilling and swilling on the HRL's first ever All-Star night. The Home Run Derby was a fun event with fireworks aplenty. Coda quickly became one of the lead attractions.
I have to be an all-three before people pass out.
Despite the Dick's antics, there was still a derby to be won. Carol Evans' Pat Sidoti tried his hand at the derby thing, and we recommend he sticks to what he's good at, reporting the news.
He can hit the off. All right. About this league, is it just the most bizarre things you've ever seen, or is it just a bunch of guys
trying to have fun? It's so much fun. You come out, everybody's lighthearted, just goes out, have a good time. You know, we all played competitive sports for a while, and this is kind of fun, nice change of speed to just get out and enjoy yourself.
Speaking from first-hand knowledge, it's a lot more difficult than it looks.
Yeah.
Well, what's it take to be good at the sport?
Just go out and have fun. None of us are really good.
That's awesome.
I think getting a little heavy over there?
No.
No, okay.
A little bit.
You used
I'll
to
let
this?
You use it next.
Oh, nice.
As the derby wound down, even Johnny Knoxville found time to take a few cuts.
What's the lead?
The final two would be teabagged from the Indians and Kmart from the Twins. After going into a sudden death round, they traded outs for a while. Finally, teabag would break the monotony. In a huge clutch moment, Kmart answers with a dong of his own to keep the derby alive.
Yeah! Hopkins!
Oh no!
Teabag would go deep again, but Kmart couldn't match it, and Teabag would be crowned the HRL's first ever home run derby champ.
Egan! Egan! Woo-hoo-hoo!
That just sucked.
That's a hell of a battle. Kmart, did a nice job. That much short.
So what kind of mojo was it that pushed you over the top? Well, how were you feeling?
Years of masturbation with this arm. The one-arm swing. Quick wrist, snap it, done. Works nice. Wonders here and at home.
Beautiful. Congrats, dude. What's the strategy, Josh?
We're going to outfun them.
Nice. That's all there is to it.
You play fun, you win.
Okay.
I'm going to go with... We're going to out... Oh, I have to bat. I'm sorry.
We're going with the tomahawk chop, baby.
All right.
Good enough for the home run derby. Good enough for the fun game.
There you go.
Once again, proving his dickness, here's Coda, plotting strategy in a frickin' fun star game.
I think we're going to really fucking
sweet, dude.
Sweet. But you come in, I'm going to shut the door. These guys suck here.
Oh, yeah.
No question.
Anything to say about this game?
Do I have anything to say about this game? All I really have to say is Egan rules. Hopkins, God, I can't believe you even fucking can even stand to hold our jocks. You fucking suck. You guys can suck a freaking nut. My nuts. You know why? You hear that? Suck my nuts. Suck my nuts.
Okay, so we've established Coda's still the main attraction, and now he's had a few too many. The Fun Star game was just that, and featured more than its share of priceless moments. Always good to see Dutch's D in mid-season form. Joe's more relaxed Zen approach to defense seems to work. Nice 40. Bob's tomahawk works wonders. Here he is, driving in gusto, who gets intimate with the backstroke. Better him than me. Peaks was tossing BP quality pitches in this one, and even though it's a fun star game, Peaks is always innovating new forms of defense, like this one. Not sure that's going to mesh well with the Padres' plans there, Peaks. More defensive ineptitude, and 10 circles the bases, putting Egan up big.
Sometimes I really scared. Deep down inside, I
have a Joe waxes philosophical. Coda nearly waxed Joe's head off. Nice. Westy's clearly on the juice. The Twins may have something here with Nelson's cut finger fastball.
Tumble.
Oh, no!
The game had plenty of fireworks, too.
Oh, oh my God!
Literally.
Remember, he's like, I thought it was in Arizona.
Well, maybe you shouldn't go around hitting people with the ball.
He's getting out of hand here, folks.
Now they're in Coda's head. Here's Pete showing some skin. Can I get a mammy on this one?
Pete's gonna get beamed.
That's why the fans voted you in.
The fans.
That's more than you hit during the home run derby.
Bam!
Believe it or not, there were some actual wiffle moments too, like this nifty double by Dutch. This game actually got way too silly and was called after 3 innings, Egan winning it by a 12-5 score.
Guys, tell us what's going to happen in this game.
Dictionary definition of dominance.
He might get the serious look on his face.
He's going to be a dominant.
Hopkins' prediction for Payne would be frightfully accurate, as Chops takes Coda yard in the first at-bat of the All-Star game for a quick 1-0 lead.
Oh! Right off the bat! Let's see that expression on Coda's face! Oh, no! Sit down, Coda! Yeah, boy!
I can't help but think
I can. Oh, he's mad now! It's just because he's so short, you can't tell.
It was not Coda's night, and soon the insults would add to the injury.
Oh, this is what a call in the game!
I know!
This is a call in! His crotch is wide open!
What do you got, buddy? Oh, that's hot. Yes!
Seen too much? Okay, here's some wiffle ball.
Go home, go home, go home!
Yeah!
Yeah!
The hit parade would lead to 5 Hopkins runs in Coda's 3 innings of work.
Nice!
Frustration led to Coda buzzing Cousin Dave's tower.
Watch out!
Meanwhile, Shirls worked the first 3 for Hopkins brilliantly, and kept the Eganites off the board, and through 3 innings, Hopkins led 5-0. Count with us. Doc faced 9 batters in the middle 3 innings, and the Southpaw mowed them all down via the strikeout. Doc would earn co-MVP honors in this game with this nasty performance. He also provided some pop at the plate against Sanchez, who allowed this lone run off the bat of Alex Valen. After 6 complete, Hopkins held a 5-1 edge. Last year's Cy Wiffle winner, Truck, took the hill for the final 3 frames, and while his stuff was truly nasty, walks were his Achilles heel. Chops would nail down co-MVP honors by launching this three-run jack into the night, giving Hopkins a cozy 9-1 edge.
Let's play!
That Hopkins shit?
Hey, baby Chops!
The man came on for Hopkins' last innings and stymied the even bats with the fireballs.
That was fast. Well, he was right, he didn't want.
Hopkins completes the domination with a convincing 9-1 win to end the festivities.